swindle him and just get a trade. But if the offer's good enough, you'll all die. So it's one of those situations. What is the style here? Are we going to see conservative smoke play? We'll have to find out. We're into the match, guys. This is map number two in this grand final between Liquid and Cloud9. Of course, Cloud9 up one map. They won cash, which was the choice of Team Liquid, in fact. They won that 16-14, very close towards the end. And now we have the pistol of Dust2, Cloud9 on CT. Fuckily already in long, though. That's actually some cool info for his team.
It's going to be interesting to see how Liquid react to this. Do they want to kill the guys on short? Or do they just want to go for a straight out long push? Seems like they're just going to try to get support.
Oh, we're getting a lot of tap downs here from Cloud9, but Elise with the double. Going to make his way back in for the entry. And Skadoodle will stop his sprint. Oh, nothing with a snap there as well. And Adren, last man standing. And he's got three players to kill. And Sean Gehez has a bullet with his name on it. And that looked like a really comfortable pistol there for Cloud9.
Yeah. I mean, the most crucial kill was that they managed to kill the game in the pit on long. That was a really nice and important kill, because as soon as they killed him, they have so much more free room to watch short, because they can stand in the slope on A. So that was a really important kill.
Okay, so double MP7, Shroud and Freakazoid. Sean Gehez on the FAMAS, Skadoodle with the Scout, and nothing with the M4. Up against Tech9 Armor, the Deke on a leash. Now, the Deke can actually be cool in a spot like this to go for the sidestep, and if they don't smoke it, like they haven't, maybe you hit that 1D. Like, maybe that happens, okay? And it can happen, man. Don't look at me like that. It can happen. And once you've eliminated the player on plat, you can actually potentially get a fast entry, because the guy who's actually inside the site itself can't really reposition. So you actually get into the bomb site. So it's one of those little gambles. Leech got tagged down to 10. So he didn't even die. So that's kind of nice. And we'll see, though, that nothing wasn't even playing plat. He's playing behind the barrels. And Liquid going to divert their play into A from the short. But that's a great lead. That's a really well-timed smoke. That's a good understanding there from Cloud9 of good smoke timings on this map. And you can see that's going to cause issues for Liquid. We have nades going through the smoke, so they're actually going to be able to get nades out in there as well for themselves and counter this play. And Nitro gets taken down, looking for the frag there on the player below in CT spawn. Now, can they get the bomb planted? That's actually going to be pretty huge. If they get the bomb down, yes, they will. Now it's just the bonus frag. That's what they're playing for. But in comes Cloud9, and they're looking up pretty much everybody. And only Sean Gehez actually took damage in that round.
Yeah, and a flawless round, a CT on Dust2 is just feels so great. I mean, a lot of teams like to go for a double op setup, and not losing a single player to that full Tech9 buy is really rare to see, and really good for Cloud9 in this game.
Now, when you're in a situation like this, are you afraid of the... Okay, they won't go for another force, but like, would you be afraid of the Tech9 armor into like a mid, into like a B split or into like an A play?
It depends. Like, I would like put more guys towards the B split because it's more common, and it's a lot more. It's way easier to retake the A site compared to the B site. So. Yeah, I would put more people there. Maybe that's why Team Liquid actually went short there, because they were expecting Cloud9 to 1 gain seed spawn.
That's actually exactly what has happened here as well. So Skadoodle with the jump scout, he's going to try to get the damage in, but of course, he's only just going to get tagged. Unless he gets a torso shot, he won't get the one-shot kill, and the Freakers are going to go up there with the spray down, gets two quick kills, pulls out the Tech9 as well. So this is another flawless round, and a round in which the MP7s picked up cash. 1,200 for Freakazoid, 600 for Shroud, and two kills even for Skadoodle with the scout there. So
we'll see how many upgrades they do.
Wow, look at that money. That is nuts. Now, there is definitely a spots where I feel like teams overdo the greed. In spots, it's like, okay, you had like flawless rounds, just go for the buy. Looks like Cloud9 and Respect that they just need to
upgrade.
Yeah,
it's a good decision. And, yeah, still only one off.
That timing pick finds the head of Freakazoid. He is sent straight back to the bench in this round. And Cloud9, I like this immediate play into upper dark for the information. They lost a player, they need to get something out of it.
And I really like that he threw the smoke there behind him, so the guy in lower could hear the smoke and not predict that they're going to push the tunnels in like the next upcoming 10 to 20 seconds.
John Gez gets the kill as well, and that might hold them in middle long enough for nothing now to actually make something happen with this flank. This play from Cloud9 is so awesome. They lost Freakazoid, but they turned that into an advantage. Not every day you can turn a death of a comrade into an advantage like this, but they're able to make it a 3v3 as Nitro does get the trade back onto nothing. But this, Cloud9 have a player who will hear everything here. It's actually, yeah, it is Sean Gez. He hears the stepping into dark from that position, I do believe. Or maybe he didn't. Do you think he heard them? I guess, well, now he hears the grenades, so he's going to flash himself in, gets the first kill. That's actually pretty awesome there for Sean Gez, as they still have yet to cross, and Skedule's in position now. He's bought them the time to maybe make something of this. But made over the top. Skedule going to look for the frag as the bomb gets faked. Shroud goes over the top, finds the kill onto Nitro. Skedule with a shot onto Adren. Oh, that was a great round from Cloud9. It really was.
Yeah, 4-0 to Cloud9. They have a lot of money in the bank. And I want to see them go for the double op now.
I have to say, I really love it when teams recognize that they have to be proactive when they get an early disadvantage to CT. Yeah. That is actually so important. Some maps it's harder than others.
Yeah, you have to take a risk. Yeah. And they played it so well. Like, filming that smoke behind them, that was really cool to see.
Sean Gez, you're not only beautiful, but you're a genius, sir. Okay, so Nitro and Adren, they're almost dead. They're almost dead.
Indeed, and it's really tough to be in that situation now. I just think they're going to go for the Fallout B-split.
It's interesting, though, because that's the perfect play here, because Cloud9 are kind of gambling towards the A-split, because they've got two players on long still. You would not normally see the second player still on long at 1 minute left in the round.
Yeah, and if they go for the B-split now, Cloud9 is actually in a lot of trouble, because they won't have any rotation whatsoever. Like, two people on long, it will take forever for them to...
Longest rotate EU. I mean, NA.
And actually gonna smoke towards B and try to take over CT spawn.
Wow. Here we go. Nothing wins the duel there against the Leech. That is very nice indeed for Cloud9. And so, the nade as well! Actually gonna finish off Adren, who was previously tagged down low. That is very unfortunate for Team Liquid, as they look for something in this round, and nice shot there by Skadoodle, and Freakazoid finds himself one as they wrap in from long. So again, they turned their long control with the information provided in mid, so the good communication, they turned the long control into a sandwiching maneuver into mid, and this is another well-crafted round on the defense from Cloud9, I would say.
Yeah, absolutely, and looks like Team Liquid is going for a tactical timeout now, and I think they need it. They have... I like that teams are using this.
Mm.
This 1 minute timeout you can take, and yeah, interesting to see what they're going to try to do. Like, I still think the Wall of Smokes would be a good option, if they have that
yeah,
in their arsenal.
This is the thing, I mean, I agree with you, and it's definitely worth trying.
It's a happy smiley face.
Good job, Producer Reese. Your orange smiley face.
Yeah, but just imagine, like, they can just smoke off the site. The only one is close to Ace again at car. So you will get the plant. And after that, I mean, sure, maybe all the CTs will be alive, but you can, like, do something, like, proactively. You can, like, okay, let's jump down the CT spawn after a flash, or, like, you try to
get in ground. Yeah, you can kind of mix it up in that way. And but that's the thing. The weird thing is that I agree with you completely about the Wall of Smoke, because it's the perfect solution to the current meta, and that's why we're starting to see it pop out often enough. But I haven't seen it in ages for some reason. And not just in NA, but in SEA and also in EU. I'm not seeing teams... Like, in EU as well, I've been seeing teams like Hellraisers when I've done some of the matches recently. They just run out and challenge the AWPer into the favorable engagement when they could just get the free plant and the AWPer is actually useless whilst the smokes are up. And then you can retreat behind the smokes and then get post-plant positions whilst the AWPer still can't do anything. And the player who's in CT spawn, who's, you know, he's useless basically. Like I think I discussed this with you previously, and you're saying, and I was asking you, what do you think is the best way to like stop that? And it's to have like that extra guy on Goose, who would be the player that's usually in CT spawn, which is why it's so strong, because you know he could then frag the
And then then he's so dedicated to A as well. Yeah. So if you would do a B split, you would like. It's a free win for the T, so it's very risky.
Yeah, it's very interesting. Very, very interesting. This is the beauty of Counter-Strike, actually. It's like it's a lot of very simple things, but combined, there's a huge amount of depth. And to find consistency is what really makes you a great team or a player. And we will have, of course, the save here from Liquid, more or less. The Eagle's coming out fugly. We've got the Tech9 armors in. The AK saved by Flosik. We go for the mid play, but they're going to get pretty much abused here. Only one player lost in nothing. And Cloud9 are on a pretty big tear at the moment. Good momentum and great cash.
And there's just... Team Liquid did the perfect counter to what Cloud9 did the previous rounds.
Right.
They're having two guys on long and one guy at car. So they're like, just walk out mid, throw the smoke, and just immediately go towards B. And Cloud9 probably thought during the timeout, okay, how are they going to counter us? Oh, they're probably going to do a B-split, so let's counter the B-split. So it just feels like Cloud9 is just one step ahead now.
And this is the other thing about Cloud9, why people have big expectations towards them. Because they're a team that have a lot of experience with that part of playing professional Counter-Strike, which is actually reading into the mind of your opponent, but doing it on like a macro level of strategy instead of like doing it on based on, oh, this guy plays in this position, this guy plays... No, but you're like actually predicting the ebb and flow of the strategic choices of your opponent. And that takes a lot of experience, I think, to do that very well. And well, we'll see Skadoodle opening things up with a really nice frag onto a Liege. And it's going to be Freakazoid with a nade over the top there in short. But it's the Dren with the pick on Sean Gez that makes things difficult now for Cloud9. Because Team Liquid still have a lot of time in the round. And they have Catwalk still. So they can still challenge into B. There is nothing stopping them going for a B play. Freakazoid, oh, he goes for the gamble, he goes for the risky push, but that's exactly what's going to pay off. But the refrag from Flosik is phenomenal, and that's going to give them the A bomb site. So it's a really good effort by Freakazoid there, but we had an equally strong counterplay coming in from Flosik. The new pickup here, newly signed pickup for Team Liquid. And he is over by sometimes referred to as the Gandalf box for... No real reason.
Obvious reasons.
Not really. Anyway, we got the retake in, and Shroud's already going to pick up Flosik. He went for the peak. At least Nitro's. It is planted for him. Go for the peak, gets the snap on, does nothing. And the second one. Oh, what a save there for Nitro. And they needed that so badly because they've been losing round after round. But at the same time, it's almost a great round for Cloud9 to win because Liquid lost almost everybody. So now... Cloud9, all they have to do is win this one, and they are very likely going to 10 or 11 rounds in this first half.
Yeah, exactly. So a lot of pressure on Team Liquid right now, and you can see they only have...
Oh, that was so nice, Skadoodle. Oh my god, that is why he got picked up by Cloud9.
That was pretty sick.
Yeah, and that is potentially the start of something that could be quite sinister for Liquid, as we were just describing on the economy, that they must win this round. And Fugly gets a great pick in too long. He just walks out. There is a lot of risk in this. Fugly gets that second one. I don't believe it, but Skadoodle's still alive. And rocking the AWP. Nothing. We'll spot push up to Xbox onto Catwalk. And Flosik gets the trade. So 2-on-2 again. Still a minute to play with for Liquid, as the bomb can be collected by Long. So Liquid have a lot of plays to work with potentially here, but Sean Gez is getting in. He's just going for the push in mid. Sean Gez wants to get some info, and all he's going to get is a bullet to the brain from Flosik. It's now Skadoodle is left alone. He needs the 4K.
And oh, yeah, Skadoodle is going to gamble. And he might actually. Oh, this is so nice by Skadoodle.
The gamble is going to pay off. Picks up the first kill. It's just Flosik left, and the bomb is down. He's committed to go and retrieve that bomb sooner than later. As Skadoodle's on the angle, he's looking for the wallbang shot, and Flosik is actually tagged. So Skadoodle, if he... Oh my god, he gets the shot! What a round from Skadoodle! And Cloud9 are going to be saved, and again, cannot emphasize the sheer importance of this round. Liquid are not buying properly for a couple rounds now.
And there's so much mind games going on in that round. the guy going up mid smoking CD spawn. He probably knows that Skadoodle isn't CD spawn at that point, and he's thinking, okay, either I can stay here and just watch the smoke, but then I still have the risk of dying because Skadoodle might have like a flash. He can throw through the smoke, for example. So okay, I'm just gonna go with my teammates. Skadoodle won't be that stupid to just run through the smoke, and Skadoodle like one step ahead, just going through the smoke, winning the round. Just great play from him.
Yep, and he's gonna get a 4K in this round as well. They're just gonna run into him. It's like they all got pistols and just running up long while Skadoodle's at the back of the A site with an AWP. So that was just like deathmatch practice for him. And he gets the almost ace. He's on 15 frags right now, so Skadoodle is definitely putting in work.
Yeah, after 9 rounds as well.
Yeah. And this is another reason why I love Counter-Strike, is because it, of course, it is such an awesome team game with so many elements of like different skill sets that are so valuable to a team. But then having a player just have a star performance in that one round, how impactful that can sometimes be, is just, you know, it's such a good game. This Counter-Strike is such a great game.
This Counter-Strike, yes.
This Counter-Strike's, it's Counter-Strikery. So Shonguez actually has the P90 right now. I'm not sure why, because Skadoodle could just easily drop him a proper gun. He's got $6,300, but no, he's like, nope,
it's
Shonguez.
Like, some players actually prefer the P90 in some positions.
Oh, we got the Noah stack there, and it's actually going to be nice here for Liquid's. Nitro's picked up a frag, and got the P90 going in, just straight through the doors. He's going to find the frag. Freakazoid gets his aggression on as well. They're playing that aggressive mid-cat setup. Cloud9 with a preemptive mix-up, and it's going to be a pretty solid situation for them as a... That incendiary, is that going to find the bomb plant spot? It will. That's going to delay the plant. Sean Gares with the place on 13 HP. And Fugly and Elise going to be finding a hard time, especially Adren, who's on 4 HP with the bomb. Now, time-wise, we're on 20 seconds left, and Cloud9 are ready to burst up Catwalk for the retake. But in comes Sean Gares with the spray down on the P90. Gets two players for a 3K in that round with that P90. And Defuse going to go on behind the smoke, and Elise just doesn't have an angle. Another round for Cloud9 as they look very strong into this second map. And again, though, we have to remember to ground ourselves here, because if we cast our minds back to a certain inferno,
yeah,
then that we had earlier today between CLG and Cloud9, we will realize that even an 11-1 advantage can still be overcome by one of these top teams.
Yeah. Absolutely, and I just love what Cloud9 did that round. They just waited. They used the bomb planting sound as a cue for when they were going to push the site. So they just waited for that sound and then just immediately pushed all four. So.
It's the little things.
Yeah. Yes.
It's the little things. It's like one of those one-liners you'll see in like an advert or something. I don't know. Commercial. I guess we're in America, so I must say commercial. We call them adverts in the UK. Anyway. Anyway, I'm sure you don't care about that. But anyway, we are in with the pistol by Freakazoid with a good bit of game sense there, knowing when to turn around. He's going to be able to pick up the frag. But the Tech 9 of Elige will claim a couple lives before he finally goes down. And Flowsick, he is not long for this world. He will get eliminated by Sean Gares' M4. And it's looking pretty strong at the moment for Cloud9. You cannot deny it.
Skadoodle with 11k, so he has a real big bank as well.
And look at his teammates' money. He should really be dropping more, to be honest. Like, one death. But seriously, he's got so much money. Should he not be dropping for his teammates? Nothing has $0, and he's got 11k. Yeah. Why is he not dropping for his teammates?
Yeah, exactly. If they lose this, I mean, nothing can't afford all the nades.
Great swap there by Adren. Goes for the pick onto B. He's going to get it. And there's a smoke. After the fact, though, so advantage Liquid in round 12. That's because you're looking to even it up.
Let's see if they're going to. Yeah, pushing Dark right away, Cloud9. This is so smart.
It's exactly what they did last time, so you would hope that Liquid would remember. Okay, last time the situation happened. Oh my god, did he get that on the jump? Wow, Skadoodle does it again. He does it again. And it's now Cloud9 taking a round back into their hands. That was once looking lost, so lost for them. Well, not necessarily lost, but very disadvantaged. And now they have to deal with their mid-push from Liquid. They're going to try to save this now. We've got Adren, Fugly, and Retro looking to get themselves in there. Good smoke in on CT to cover the approach into the B-bomb site. In goes Fugly. Oh, the flash was not quite perfect, but Fugly is going to deliver anyway. But can they take down John Gez? They will get the frag. Nitros and Adren left alive. Great shot there from Adren, taking down Shroud. But Skadoodle's left. This guy's been a menace. Absolute menace so far. Going to go in with the AK, swapping it straight out, and very anticlimactic there as he runs in and promptly dies.
Yeah, and still only two survivors there for Liquid, so if Cloud9 manages to win this round, gonna put a lot of pressure there on Liquid. And as you said, Nothing, or Skadoodle should have dropped that last round. Look at Nothing, he only has one smoke now.
And a decoy. Oh my god, it makes me sick to my stomach. Skadoodle, another opening kill there. And when this is the reason why I was a bit afraid. Wow! I don't even know where to begin with that. Flowsick, he is going to even the situation straight up. So.
Okay. That never happened to me.
I'm going to walk out, fire these two bullets through this smoke, yeah. And the guy's going to die.
Oh, yeah. Oh, nice.
So, four versus
it's so
four.
So random.
And that smoke can also be a fake. You can't like preempt the rotate with something like this, especially with the delay that they're putting in. Waiting this long then to go in, it's like super mind games going on here from Team Liquid, and they know they have that pick towards B. I think we have the second player in B though. Yep, he's in a very dangerous position as well. Nothing is in a position to make Liquid cry if they do not spot this on the entry. If they do go in for the play, very, very painful indeed. So they're trying to spot a rotation. They're trying to get another frag. There's the re-smoke. Now the Cloud9 know that they're committed to this. With this much time left in the round, they know it's got to be the B play. They're already rotating Shroud towards the B-bomb site. Slowly but surely, Skadoodle gets the first shot. Nothing peeks out. Gets a double. Now Flowsick comes in from the rotate for the lurk. Can't make it happen against Shroud and Cloud9. They are going to money screw Liquid once again. Liquid cannot catch a break. And it all started with Cloud9 getting a ridiculous economy at the start of this half.
Yeah, 11-2 now. Team Liquid on an eco, probably gonna be 12-2 at least. So at least 12 rounds this half for Cloud9. I can't really see Team Liquid coming back from this.
But it's Counter-Strike, so it can happen.
Yeah, there are deagles, so.
Yeah, there is. Never gonna let this go. We actually had a discussion about cost efficiency of the pistols in the break. Maybe we can talk about that later. But I even have some other stuff written down I wanted to talk about. It's talking points for after the match. Anyway, pretty Cloud9 defending against the pistol push, and they are going to line up. So looking pretty good. But Nitro's over the top through the window, able to pick up a frag, but there's too many Cloud9 players left. But Alish gets it done with the Glock onto Nothing, and that's going to be the bomb down. And they picked up two rifles. They don't have any armor, so the aim punch is always a problem. But if they get the fast headshots, it will not matter. And Nitro is playing a headshot position into the dark. He needs to get the fast dark frag, but they're just swarming too quickly. And he will only get one frag so far. He looks for the second, almost gets it. But Freakazoid will extinguish Nitro's flame in that round. And we have another one for Cloud9 as they are basically putting Liquid in that just horrible spot on the money. Like, it's just so hard to deal with. Because it's like the momentum thing. Like, they just, you get three rounds, you never feel pressured on your own economy, unless you're everyone but Skadoodle, because Skadoodle basically is keeping all the money. He's like the bank of the team. He's still the richest guy. I mean, he's died, what, three times now in 15 rounds, 14 rounds.
Yeah, I'm not upgrading his pistol either, last round.
We get the long take coming in from Liquid. Couple players, including the bomber. I'm not sure if they spotted the bomber, because that kind of gives the game away. They show the bomb in long right now. Re-smoke here from Freakazoid, showing that he really needs to keep himself for this challenge. He does not want to give up long. Oh my god, if he can get around the side, they won't spot him. Spots the bomb, so they know 100%. They've already started the rotation, but Alish comes out with two fantastic, exquisite frags. And that's going to create a situation now for Liquid where they have advantage. Bomb still needs to make it to the site, though. That is the big problem here for them. And Fugly, they might just toss the bomb across. There it is, there's the toss. Oh, Sean gets spots. He's ready. He gets the kill, and the bomb drops further forward. In comes Nitro from the side, though, and he's going to get nothing nailed from the top, and it's going to be 12-3, Cloud9. But the three rounds is actually a big deal. But...
Oh, you mean the last round?
Yeah, getting three rounds is a big deal, but it looks pretty bad.
Yeah, it's... Cloud9 should be able to close it out.
There's no sugarcoating it.
Yeah, exactly. I mean... they have so much breathing room now. They can just keep doing, like, going for straight A pushes and being, like, consistent with defending A pushes is really hard on this map.
They have a B spawn.
They should not go for the B, although.
But they got the spawn threat. Please explain.
They have the spawn, so they're closer to it, which means they will get there faster.
They're going for it, man. They got the B spawn. Oh, okay, maybe not. Maybe not immediately, at least. Oh, we have the push from Liquid. Fancy stuff coming in. Now, this is really actually very good practice stuff because the CTs have long rotations, so they want to get in on the info straight away. Ooh, the engagement. The baiting. The baiting is real right now. At least he even picks up a kill. Now Nitro goes in, but he goes down straight away with no frags. That is a problem for Liquid. They still don't know what's going on, though. They really needed a frag out of Nitro there. That would have been so good to get an advantage. And they're going to go back into T spawn because they do not want to show in mid where Alicia's been peeking and where he can probably hear them moving around.
Yeah, it's probably based on schedule, not hearing anyone on long. So they just want to like walk close long because they probably know that someone's going to stand on site and peek them. So they should just stand close to the corner here and just run as soon as they see him.
Adren. He... is the man.
Like that. Okay, that
okay,
was
he's dead.
Perfect play from Cloud9.
Yeah, that's really well done. And Adren in that position, I mean, you got four guys facing you with a Glock. Even at the range, you're going to probably die very quickly, and he did. But the retake comes in. We got a couple Kevlars, a kit on Flosik. Adren also had a kit, and he died on the bomb, basically. They're going to go in fast right now, looking for those quick headies, and he's going to be a quick couple found by them, but still... Cloud9 with the advantages, Fugly with everything to do, and Liquid will lose the pistol round on CT.
And Liquid will have to force by now, of course.
I'm afraid for Liquid right now. This is one of those spots where you have to be able to eliminate the fact that you're basically about to lose the game away from your mind to play the best round that you possibly can and be really present. It's a pretty important skill set as well in the mind of any athlete, but
no scout though. It's really surprising.
How many kills did they get on the pistol round? There was a couple.
Yeah,
kills.
Yeah,
they could have afforded one or two.
They bought a deagle.
Oh my
instead.
God! Actually, you're right. Could he have afforded one?
Yeah.
Because that, yeah, you would always prefer the scout. You need at least one or two scouts. It's so good actually on Dust 2. It's one of the maps where it's super good. You can abuse it a lot. Couple tags makes a really big difference, but we'll see if they can make the pistols work here. We've got he's going for the angle where a scout would be very, very nice, because the armor here doesn't help him massively, because if he gets touched, he's going to get headshotted probably. So, headshot angle. Ooh, there's the first shot. Looking for more, using the barrels there to keep himself... Oh my goodness! And threats. Fugly is like... You what, mate? Deeks for days. The round won by Liquid, 4-13. They have three survivors pick up two AKs.
We could put a bot there, standing AFK, and I could shoot like seven bullets for the deagle, and that wouldn't happen. Like, and I could pre-aim it.
Hey, well, Threat, you know, I'm going to have to take you through my aim training, my mechanics training,
yeah.
And you'll be able to hit deagles like that in no time. All right, so great stuff there. Actually, very nicely done. Again, that's kind of a crazy play, and it worked out really well for Liquid against Cloud9. Cloud9 not going for the traditional approach of the long play or the short play in anti-eco, but instead this time they're going to, my goodness, run into the spray down, the epic spray down. Liquid players just filling my screen on the kill tracker, and it's 5-13 now as Cloud9 need to go for an eco.
And this might actually start to get dangerous now for Cloud9, because They're going for a full eco again, which they should do, but it still means Team Liquid will be able to build some bank.
Ooh, we have two smokes. Are we going to see a almost full wall of smokes on A for the plants?
Yeah, I think so.
This could be good. I hope they have this execute. This is Envious used to do this all the time, pretty much. They would like you would know that they were going to do it as well, but yeah. It's so good. So, but actually no, they're using it for mid in fact, and saving one for post plant perhaps. As well, they're all going to get caught actually moving up into the B area. That's kind of the problem here with these smokes. Even a team kill at least decides that Nitro is not worth keeping alive in this round. He's just going to go and just deal with matters, getting his hands dirty. They're just running straight through the smoke, and Shroud is not really in the best position in the world here with 20 HP, no Kevlar. Although that's actually kind of a nice angle, I must say. I like that angle. That angle.
That angle, though.
That angle. And, well, there's no reason for him to move unless he's, you know, it's like 15 seconds and he wants to, like, not die off the time. That's the only reason to really move. Do you think he should...
Assume he
can never save in this spot. Yeah,
exactly. It's just the risk of dying after the time goes out is not worth it, so... Just wait a bit, see if someone pushes you. Just go out and try to get a pick.
We actually saw a hilarious spot yesterday. I think when Cloudman played Tempo Storm, I think it was. We were on Inferno. There was Cloudman were playing CT, and it was on Inferno. And like three or four Cloudman guys were left alive. And there's one guy for Tempo Storm, I can't remember, he was alive. The time ran out on the B site. But Cloudman just waited like 20 seconds, basically, to kill him. But he wouldn't push. To die basically, so they just waited to try to kill him after time. Then he ran at them, but they all like started bunny hopping around to not get shot. So like four guys are bunny hopping around him to not get shot, and then they like kill him after time, but he can't kill any of them.
Yeah.
Even though none of them are shit.
Yeah, it was
actually hilarious, but really smart, yeah. Anyway, back into the action here as we go for the cat take as Cloud9 look for the entry with Skedule. The Noah stack though, ooh, bit of a shallow angle there. Skedule gets the trade. Almost caught the second shot. That's actually great game sense as well, to know to put the shot in at that timing, knowing that the player there would be a second player there. But doesn't get lucky this time. Flash over the top there from Nitro to slow down any players who looked to push Flowsick on short. So Liquid abandoning long.
And Cloud9 seems to be ruining this, pushing long now. Plus, they're leaving one guy at Xbox, which is really important.
Yeah, and two on B and for Liquid and two on Catwalk for A. But again, the lack of long control can be an issue because Skedoodle is alive with an AWP and he's on long now. Now, they can play retake, but it's going to be difficult. So I think they'd rather try to get a couple kills as they try to cross. But it's just a Dren there at the moment. It's all on nothing on the lurk here, and Skedoodle on the entries as they make their way up onto the site. Okay, they're going to hide onto the site here. They're going to try to plant for Skedoodle. He's on long. Oh, and Adren's going to pop out, but gets actually one frag, but he's still alive over by the Gandalf position, one of those boxes. Mostly going to stop the push from short. And now Skedoodle needs to help out, but Shroud has got the number of Adren and Flowsick, and will proceed to eliminate them both. So Cloud9 picking up another round. They're two away from taking this and the grand finals here for the HTC Reborn Invitational.
And Liquid can't afford to buy this round, but if Cloud9 win this, it puts them on 15 rounds and Team Liquid on like $2,000 on each player. So a must-win round for Team Liquid.
Oh, he does it again. Dirtiest of frags as the CT is crossed. Always very, very hard to deal with. Oh dear. Two players going down on the buy round, trying to just cross it into the site. We got to push in upper dark. As Fugly tried to make something happen, but Cloud9 looking too good at the moment. Elige and Flowsick trying to go for the hero moves. Hand in hand through long. Do get a quick kill into Shroud, but the bomb's going to go down here on B. So the retake options don't look too good here for Team Liquid.
They should just try to save. Yeah, Cloud9 saw both players on the death cam there, so I think they're feeling really comfortable right now.
To be honest, for me as well, a lot of this comes down to that round where Skedoodle did a 4K kind of clutch with the AWP.
Yeah, actually.
To money screw them on the CT side. Because if that not happens, then Team Liquid can very realistically push Cloud9 off of good money as a CT, and then it's like a completely different game. Because we've seen their CT, from Team Liquid to be very strong. From Cloud9 be very strong when they never ever had to worry about money, not even a single round.
Yeah, that's actually true. And yeah, just look at Liquid's economy now. They saved two weapons, sure, but the other players can't afford anyway. Dropped one Famas, Flowsick. What will they buy? CZ on Nitro, Deagle on Fugly.
Like how you always make a point to pull that reference out there. The Deeks for days. Cloud9 moving in for a fast push. They want to end this grand final right here, right now, on match point. And Fugly gets the first Deek, looks for the second, but this time he will not deliver. 3-on-3, so decent damage done, but Cloud9 in with a very good advantage on this retake. Skidoodle gonna take down Flowsick, eliminating any play from Upper Dark. And Cloud9 now just need to hold on against Elise and Adren from the doors, but they still have grenades to use. Just a couple HEs. And Elise gonna go in now and with Adren to make it happen. They both get eliminated straight away. And congratulations, we have a winner, Cloud9. Will actually win 2-0 over Team Liquid, and they will be crowned the champions at the HGC Reborn Invitational. So I have to say, I didn't expect this. We saw Cloud9 almost get eliminated by Tempo Storm 2-0. So they've come back into this from a shaky quarterfinal. They improved into the semifinal, and they brought their A game into the grand final.
Yeah, it actually looked kind of like easy in this final for Cloud9. Sure, the score on Cash was 16-14, but they were up like 15-8, and they just like couldn't really close the game out. And Dust2, they were just superior.
Absolutely. Dust2, like one of those huge momentum maps, and I feel we didn't get to see the best opportunity for a CT side to even start happening, the money, you know, and all that, and then this schedule, he just turned it on, and that's a large reason why they couldn't get a chance on the CT side. Schedule was just, dude, he was hitting everything. He had crazy rounds again. That key round where he money screwed them around, I think it was like the ninth round. I think they were like 8-1 at that point, and then he made it of course 9-1, and then no money.
Yeah,
for them,
and
so
the decisions just walk through the smoke there through Cedar Spawn. That was so cool.
Yeah, he's showing exactly why he's considered the best AWPer in NA. So really cool to see Cloud9 actually have a really good tournament here. And Liquid as well, you know, making it to the final. I think, you know, that's going to feel good. They've got a lot to take away from this as well. Any thoughts for you whilst we close this one out?
No, just really impressed by both Cloud9 and actually Affinity, which I actually hadn't heard of any of the players in that team. And they beat Keed 2-0, and they did lose 2-0 to Liquid, but that game could have gone like either way.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, guys, so thank you so much for watching. We hope you've enjoyed the show here, and HTC, massive thanks to them for, you know, putting this tournament up and giving us this awesome opportunity to see all these great, great matches, because we had a lot of best of threes. Actually, it was super cool to see every best of three for all the quarterfinals for some of the best teams in the North America region. And of course, you know, thanks also to all the other sponsors here that have been helping out. You've got Cyberpower PC, Quest Gaming, of course. And also we have the G2A and Faceit as well, who have been helping out here. And of course, you know, I'm going to thank myself, because apparently I'm the CEO of Faceit. I'm the main admin of Faceit. I developed the website. But this is the questions I get. Like, people send me loads of messages like, hey, can you fix my account? Can you ban this guy? Can you unban me? Like, I heard that like DDK is an investor in the company. You know, all this kind of stuff. People think that I'm doing everything, even
yeah,
in production.
But you are. So, like, if you have any questions, if you need someone banned on Faceit, just,
no, please.
Just send a private message to Dan here.
Oh, God. But yeah, it's been a great tournament, and I hope to see HTC going more and more into Counter-Strike. This is their first tournament, so excellent stuff from them. Again, lastly, I think the giveaway is still open. So go to, of course, bit.ly/giveaway/HTC, and you can enter the giveaway to win one of the Cyberpower PCs that have been provided by them, and also, of course, the wonderful HTC One M9, which we've been showing off here and there with some wonderful selfies across the couple of days of the tournament. So that's it from us here tonight, guys. But of course, you can catch me in Threat, and also James much more in the future, casting some awesome Counter-Strike near you for North American matches in the Faceit League. Of course, our European matches, Star Series. We're going to be all over the place with awesome Counter-Strike action. But that is all for tonight. We hope you've enjoyed the show. Thank you so much, and good night.